All right, this is installment number 4, and this is going to be the peg leg that goes on the bottom of the walking stick. And I've done an offset again. I'm going to do 4 turnings. I'm going to do down the line here. And this is a hickory shovel handle, and it tears out pretty bad, so there's going to be a fair amount of sanding when I'm done, but the rest of it's fairly rustic, so it shouldn't make that much difference. I'm going to use my round nose scraper once again, like a gouge. And there you see we've gotten that round almost completely because I'm not using quite as much offset as I did on the elm. And the other thing I got to tell you is this is so much easier to machine than that elm was. It's just unbelievable. So there we've got one journal, and I'll move down the line and I'll do the other ones in succession. All right, let's do journal number 2. And we'll move down the line and we'll readjust our tailstock and we'll do journal number 3. Sharpened the scraper. It was a little bit dull. Made a much nicer cut, but it's still a lot of tear outs. There's journal number 3. In fact, my 3 is still on there. I haven't got quite down that deep, but I'm going to finish sanding that. So we have 1, 2, 3, and they are alternating 1/4 each time. We're going to loosen this up and we're going to move over to number 4. Number four's got a fair amount of offset. It'll have the most. I'm going to grab a gouge here because I want to get down here, but I have to leave this last little place here for a tenon for the, and you can't quite see it, can you? I need to leave this last piece here for a tenon in order to attach it to the post, whatever I'm going to use for a foot on here. So I'm going to use a spindle gouge. In this case, I think it's ground like a roughing gouge. Just enough to finish off this last little piece here. Got that. Sitting a little high there. Now the basic three or four offsets are on here, and they spiral down to the bottom. So I'm going to hit some sandpaper on that. I'm going to center this up, sand it up, and then I have to turn a tenon on this end to receive the rubber foot, and I have to turn a tenon on the other end to match my fitting where the two pieces come together. We're going to turn the tenon here on the top end so that it's able to be screwed into the fitting on the other end. I'm going to use a scraper that I made. This is a flat nose scraper. It used to be a V-nose scraper, and I use it, once again, just the same way I do a gouge. Rub the bevel, and then come down. I want a slight taper on this because, it being a pipe thread, it's a tapered pipe thread. I got to sneak up on this real careful. Two problems here. I don't want to get involved with my live center, and I also don't want to make it too small. Close. Okay, after removing this from the lathe two or three times and testing it, we end up with a really good dry fit. It'll screw in easier with the epoxy because the epoxy kind of works like a lubricant. So now what I'm going to do is finish some sanding on this. Once again, we're not going for that polished finish look. And this piece will be ready to be installed on the staff. Okay, now what's left to do is to marry these two pieces together, and we will make sure that that's a good snug fit, and I may have to go out and shim that just a little bit, or shave this back just a little bit. When I sanded it, it got a little bit thin, but in any case, we'll end up with a nice tight screw fit in here, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. And this is how it's going to look. The glue is on the cure. I'll make some adjustments before the glue sets, but you can see, there we are. I have stained the top half, and it still needs some touch-ups on the stain. I'm going to stain the bottom half, and then I'll give it a good coat of spray lacquer, clear, put the foot on it, and we're pretty well finished. All right, on to the next one. Come back. Bye for now.